And a round of applause as they come to their first stop. And a round of applause as they come to their second stop. All flamingos can mix similar to a fountain carrot. Without that carotenoid pigment in their diet, their new feathers will grow in white instead of pink. So in order to maintain their natural pink color here at the zoo, their food already has that red pigment added to it. And a round of applause as they come to their third stop. Flamingos are incredibly specialized birds, and they have to be in order to survive in their harsh salt lake habitat. One of their body adaptations include their beak, which if you look closely has the larger portion at the bottom rather than at the top, unlike most birds. This is because they are filter feeders, which means that they tip their heads upside down in the water to capture microscopic shrimp, insects, mollusks, algae, and grasses, and then by pressing their tongues against their beak, they'll strain these particles right out of the water. Also take note of their webbed feet. In addition to swimming, these help them cross the muddy areas of the habitat. Now when a flamingo stand on one leg, lots of people think that they're the strange bird. Like, why do you even need to stand on one leg for that long? It's actually a very, very logical explanation, because you have to keep in mind that they only weigh 8 pounds. Most of that weight is not distributed across their skinny little legs, so when the temperature drops even a little bit like it has today, they will lift their legs up to their bodies to stay warm. In addition to that, standing on
one on his back.